Have you been wondering why do you feel the way you do? Why do you behave the way you do? Why do you tend to make such irrational decisions sometimes? Why are you so emotional and why does it feel like you cannot take control over that at all? Why does it feel impossible to stick with your plan? Hello there guys and welcome to FTMO. My name is Nelly and I'm here giving you the tools and resources to manage your trading psychology. And I hope you all are doing well. And today I'm gonna explain why we tend to react as we do in certain situations, how our brains work and how it influences our decision making and how to overcome it. So, as you probably already know, when it comes to trading, up to 80% of success is devoted to psychology. However, as you will realize after watching this video, your psychology is highly connected to your strategy, and without a proper strategy and correct risk management, it will be impossible to feel relaxed, calm, and become consistently profitable. Handling your emotions is much easier when you use those strategies you can devote your trust into, as they have proven to be reliable over time. You know what you can expect. You backtested them, you've been using them for some time, and everything is properly calculated. You know in advance what you may lose or what is going to be your profit. You are sticking with the plan you've set, and you are not deceiving yourself. On the other hand, if you have a strategy that you haven't backtested properly, the strategy you're not really sure about, this is when it comes difficult, as our brains perceive this type of situation as a huge danger. But why is that? Well, have you ever heard about the part of the brain called the amygdala? This part plays a critical role in processing emotions, especially fear and emotional memory, to protect us from danger. Amygdala is an ancient part of our brain, which has been actually saving our lives throughout the tens of thousands of years. This small, almond-shaped part of our brain helps coordinate responses to things in our environment, especially those that trigger an emotional response. The structure plays an important role in fear and anger. It is a part that just can't handle any uncertainty, as it wants to keep us alive. And when it comes to trading, especially when you trade in a manner when you are not truly conscious of your intentions, our brain perceives this as a huge danger, as a potential killer. As money keeps us alive, it is our certainty. It makes us feel secure. Thanks to money, we can eat and we have a roof over our heads. So, obviously, if you're not using a proper, reliable strategy, if you're not ready, your brain will panic because, let's be honest, you don't know what is going to happen. And thus, your brain will perceive your trading as a predator, as something dangerous. Because seeing that we start losing money triggers that uncertainty, that fear. And then we tend to panic and behave exactly in the manner we don't want to. Because in our brain, the amygdala receives inputs from all senses, sends a distress signal to the hypothalamus, and the hypothalamus gets the ball rolling, telling your adrenal glands to release the stress hormones, adrenaline and cortisol. And you get yourself into the mode which is called fight, flight or freeze. The mode when your brain is telling you, run away from the situation, save yourself. And you will close your trades too soon or too late in the unfavorable moments. You will do revenge trading, over trading, and it will all become just toxic. But how to overcome it? Well, the only way is to know yourself properly, to be self-aware. If you know what are your strengths and weaknesses, if you know what you enjoy and what you don't like, it will be much easier to find a strategy that will work for you and which you will enjoy. And these feelings of uncertainty and fear will slowly disappear once you find your strategy, once you backtest it properly and also have the right risk management. However, please be also aware that this can take months. Hear my strong suggestion. When it comes to doing your research, your experiments with new strategies, please just use your demo account. Use your demo account and backtest that strategy properly before using it in the real market. You won't blow up your account, it will save your money, you'll be able to handle your emotions a lot better, and you'll also learn to be patient. You need a well-known strategy that you can rely on. Learn how to handle your pre-calculated losses and profits. And over some time, your brain will finally realize that you are not in danger and you'll stop breaking your own rules. You will no longer be stressed out, as you and your brain will know exactly what you are going to do. Your mind will be put at ease. Are you currently using a demo account? Are you backtesting certain strategies? And how is it going? Let us know in the comment section below. Also, if you haven't done it yet, hit the like, subscribe, and don't forget to follow FTMO on all socials. Thank you for watching, guys, and good luck with your trading and trading psychology.